In this video, I want to define a line integral of a scalar field and show you how to convert a line integral into an ordinary one-dimensional integral. So we'll be working in the plane. A line integral means we have some curve. Say, we'll call that curve C. We have a coordinate system, an XY coordinate system. We'll be working in the XY plane. So this is X and this is Y. We can represent a point on this curve then by a vector. We'll call that R. To do a line integral, we break up this curve into small pieces. We'll call these small pieces ds, length ds. And then the definition then is in terms of a Riemann sum. So we're going to write the integral along the curve of some function of r ds. What that means in terms of the Riemann sum is that we broke this curve up into these small elements of length ds. Everywhere on the curve, we have some value of the function f of r. We're going to just take the average in these small elements, and then we're going to sum up all of the values of f times all of the length ds over the whole curve C that we specify. So that's a Riemann sum definition of the line integral. Okay. What is this ds, right? If we have our ds here, small element ds, this ds consists of a dx and a dy. And we have Pythagorean's theorem, so that ds then is going to be equal to the square root of dx squared plus dy squared. Okay? That will be our ds in terms of the Cartesian dx and dy. Okay, so there are two methods of doing this type of integral. The first method, let's say that this curve is specified by a function. So y equals some function of x, right? So it's a curve of y versus x. Then dy here is going to be equal to y prime of x dx. And our ds then is equal to the square root of dx squared plus dy squared, which will be y prime of x dx squared. And you see that the dx squared then we can factor out. So that becomes the square root of 1 plus y prime of x squared dx. Okay? So we can do the whole integral then in terms of x. And we get this integral then over the curve of f of r ds becomes an integral then from the initial value of x to the final value of x on the curve of f. R then is the point, will be the point x, and the y coordinate, which will be y of x given in terms of x. And the ds then is the square root of 1 plus y prime of x squared dx, a one-dimensional integral, okay? So provided we know the functional form for the curve, y equals y of x in the xy plane, then the line integral of f along that curve, the integral along the curve f of r ds, can be written in terms of a one-dimensional integral in x. F of x, y, which is a function of x, times the square root of 1 plus the derivative of y with respect to x squared dx, okay? That's the first method. The second method for computing this type of line integral is if this curve is parameterized. So a parameterization of the curve would say that x then is some function of t for this curve, and y is also some function of t. Okay? So then what is dx and dy? In that case, then dx is equal to dx dt times dt. I'm going to use the notation x dot for dx dt. So dx dt times dt. And dy then is dy dt, or y dot times dt. Then our ds in the line integral is the square root of this squared plus this squared, which will be the square root of x dot of t squared plus y dot of t squared. And then both terms have dt in them, so then dt, okay? So we can write our element of the curve ds in terms of x dot squared plus y dot squared square root dt. Okay, so again, the integral along the curve, f of r ds, then in terms of the parameter t, is equal to the integral from the initial value of t to the final value of t, so the start of the curve to the end of the curve, of f of r, so that would be f of x of t, y of t, right? So a function of t times ds. So ds here will be the square root of x dot of t squared plus y dot of t squared square root dt, a one-dimensional integral. Okay, let me summarize. I'm defining the line integral of a scalar field, f of r is our scalar field, as a Riemann sum. So you have a small element of length ds and a value of f on that element. We multiply them together, the length times the value of f, and then we sum over all of the elements on the curve. And that's the definition of this integral. Okay. To do this integral, we show that ds is just the square root of dx squared plus dy squared, and there's two possible ways to do this integral. One, if we know that y is a function as a function of x, so we have the curve y equals y of x, then the integral can be done in x from the initial value of x to the final value of x, of f of x times of x, f of x, y of x, so y is supposed to be known as a function of x, times this factor, square root of 1 plus 1 prime of x squared dx, a single variable integral. The other way of doing it is if the curve is parameterized, so x is a function of time, and or t, it doesn't have to be time, but any parameter t, y is a function of t, then we can write dx as x dot dt, dy equals y dot dt, and ds then becomes the square root of x dot squared plus y dot squared times dt. Then using our parameter t, we can integrate through this line integral starting at t naught, ending at tf, and then having f, which now is a function of t, times this factor dt. I'm Jeff Chasnoff. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.